Hello, this is Dr. Miller again, and in this video I will be looking at the importance of igneous mineral composition for igneous rock classification. All igneous minerals in igneous rocks have a certain percentage of the element silica, and therefore are called silicate minerals. The specific composition of a given igneous rock is determined by the temperature to which the molten magma cools. Not the rate at which it cools, but the temperature to which that magma cools. And the reason for this is that each silicate mineral has a specific crystallization or freezing temperature. So as a hot molten magma cools, different silica minerals will crystallize out or freeze out at different temperatures. This relationship is summarized by Bowen's reaction series flowchart, which is present in your lab reading.
Those minerals with a low silica content and high iron and magnesium content, on this side of the diagram, crystallize or freeze at higher temperatures than those minerals with a high silica content and low iron and magnesium content, on this side of the diagram. Therefore, as a magma cools, different minerals will crystallize out in a predictable sequence. And that sequence is represented by Bowen's reaction series. In Bowen's reaction series, the top of the diagram represent high magma temperatures, and the bottom of the diagram represent lower magma temperatures. The high temperature minerals with a high content of iron and magnesium are called mafic. The term is a contraction of magnesium and ferric, derived from the Latin word for iron. Mafic minerals include olivine, pyroxene, and amphibole. The low temperature minerals with a high silica content are called felsic. Felsic minerals include potassium feldspar, also called orthoclase feldspar, muscovite mica, and quartz. The term felsic is derived from a contraction of the words feldspar and silica, therefore the word felsic.
So let's take a look at a collection of igneous rocks. It turns out that in general, those mafic minerals, those high in iron and magnesium content, have a darker color. And those felsic minerals with a high silica content have a lighter color. This general trend will be helpful in classifying your igneous rock samples. I will first sort out those rocks, separating the darker mafic rocks from the lighter felsic rocks. So we'll separate out the darker minerals here, the darker colored rocks first here, and lighter colored rocks here. So you have darker colored rocks here, lighter colored igneous rocks here. And notice that there are some specimens that have a mixture of dark and light minerals, and these are appropriately referred to as intermediate. So here we have mafic minerals, mafic rocks, intermediate rocks, and felsic rocks. So going from darker colors to lighter colors. Now, within this group of dark mafic rocks, you will note that some are coarse-grained, in which you can easily see the individual mineral grains. Some are fine-grained or aphanitic, in which you cannot see the mineral grains. And some are glassy or vesicular, as in this case. Although all of these rocks have a similar chemical composition, we know from the previous video that they cooled at different rates. So the phaneritic rocks, the coarse-grained rocks, cooled at slower rates than the aphanitic rocks, and the glassy or vesicular ones occurred essentially instantly. And the same is true here for the felsic rocks. Because the phaneritic rocks have mineral grains large enough to see, you can identify the component minerals using the mineral properties from the previous lab. So you will find the properties of, say, cleavage, fracture, and hardness to be the most useful. So in looking at an individual rock sample, you can see these individual mineral grains, and you'd be able to notice where they show fracture, where they show cleavage surfaces, and you might be able to determine their hardness as well. On the other hand, rocks that are aphanitic, the mineral grains are not visible to the naked eye, and you can use color as an indicator of general composition. So with these tools, you are now free to identify the mineral igneous rock specimens in your collection.